Hello students, welcome back. In continuation to the last video, here we are again with the same topic, cleaning organization with different subtopics. Myself, Paramveer Singh, Associate Professor with Chitkara School of Hospitality. In today's video, we will study about the following cleaning methods, that is traditional cleaning method or orthodox or conventional cleaning method, block cleaning method, team cleaning method, deep cleaning or special projects, and spring cleaning. So let's begin. Orthodox or conventional or traditional cleaning method. In this way of cleaning, a GRA completes all the tasks in one guest room before going on to the next room in the section allotted to him or her. So that means the number of rooms given to a GRA to clean in a day, he finishes the task in one room, he completes the cleaning of one room, and then he shifts to the next guest room for the cleaning. On an average, a GRA may be required to clean 12 to 16 rooms in an 8 hour work day or work shift. So that means on an average, a GRA takes around 30 minutes to clean a guest room. And in case 30 rooms are for a standard room, and in a case if a suite room is there, so that room takes almost doubles the time of a standard room. That's why the variation of 12 to 16 rooms is there. So in the traditional cleaning method, a GRA completes one room, which includes cleaning of the room, changing of the linen, setting of the amenities, cleaning of the bathroom, setting of the amenities in the washroom, and everything is done. Once the room is finished, then GRA moves to the next room in the particular section or the area or the number of rooms allotted to him for a day. Next is block cleaning. In this way of cleaning, the GRA moves from room to room and completes the same task in every room before returning to begin the cycle again for the next task on the list. So in this method, a particular set of area is allotted to a GRA, and GRA complete the task, the one task in all the rooms, and then he again move to the first room and then do the second task in all the rooms. For example, let's suppose a GRA has to clean 5 rooms at a stretch. So he will do the bed making of all the rooms first, then do the dusting, then do the bathroom part. So he will take all the tasks in a go, like complete the one task in all the rooms first, then take the second task, then finishes all the second task in the all the rooms, and then take the third task, and so on. This involves blocking several rooms at a time to form a room section, and usually more than one GRA will be at work in the section. So in this way, two or more GRAs can be clubbed together to do a particular task. For instance, one GRA might take all the beds in a particular room section. As I have told you, let's suppose they have blocked 5 rooms and then they need to clean. So one GRA will make all the beds in the 5 rooms, then he will take the second task, the second GRA will clean all the WCs in all the rooms, and then he will take all the bathtubs, and so on. For instance, one GRA might take all the beds in that particular room section while another GRA cleans the toilet, and the third GRA dusts and cleans the area, replenishing supplies that are low. Next is team cleaning. In this method, two or more people work together in the same area, either on the same task or on different tasks. So two people, they are allowed to form a group to complete the particular set of tasks given to them. To organize the team cleaning of guest rooms, two GRAs may be scheduled to clean 30 to 35 guest rooms in a day. As I have told, one GRA takes around 30 minutes to clean a room, and in 8 hours shift, he cleans around 16 rooms. So two GRAs, the output will be more in terms of individual. So 16 plus 16 is 32. So that's how 30 to 35 rooms can be cleaned when the team is formed. Deep cleaning and special projects. Deep cleaning refers to the intensive cleaning schedule in which periodic cleaning tasks are scheduled for monthly, quarterly, half yearly or annual frequencies. Deep cleaning required special expertise to clean the particular sections of the hotel. Deep cleaning involves some tasks that require the housekeeping department to work in coordination with the maintenance department. In deep cleaning, in the case of deep cleaning, the room need to be blocked. They are not, the front office is not allowed to sell those rooms. And once the room is blocked, then housekeeping in coordination with maintenance department, they take the task of cleaning the particular areas. Many tasks involved in deep cleanings are complicated and time consuming ones, requiring special equipments, special techniques, expertise and group effort. The tasks are usually scheduled as special projects and they might be given on contract basis to the agencies which are expertise in that particular cleaning. Deep cleaning tasks include the following: shampooing of the carpets, vacuum cleaning of the upholstery, mattress and bed bases, rotating and turning of the mattresses, thoroughly cleaning of furniture and polishing of wooden furniture, stripping, resealing, repolishing and buffing of the floors. Shampooing of the carpets, it's not done on regular basis. It can be done on quarterly or half yearly or annual basis. Plus, it also depends upon the type of stain they have on the carpet. And for this, there are special expertise which are required to do the carpet cleaning or the shampooing of the carpets. It's not a regular job. Vacuuming or cleaning of upholstery, mattress and bed bases, that can be done by the GRA itself. Rotating and turning of mattress is done by the GRAs. Thoroughly cleaning of furniture and polishing of wooden furniture is done by the maintenance department. Stripping, resealing, repolishing and buffing of floors, again that depends upon the type of floor. If it is a wooden floor or a tiled floor or a marbled floor, that again depends. Wooden floors can be stripped or ceramic floors can be stripped and then they can be relaid again. They can be resealed. So expertise from the maintenance department are required. Cleaning hard to reach areas such as ceilings, top edges of doors, fans, air conditioning vents and so on. They also require deep cleaning because they cannot be cleaned on regular basis or on daily basis. So they need to be planned and then they need to be cleaned. Cleaning ornate lighting fixtures such as chandeliers. Chandeliers are one of the costliest item. So they need proper expertise to clean. They need to be lowered down. And in most of the hotels, the chandeliers are cleaned during the night time when there is less footfall or when there is less traffic in the lobby. Then it is lowered down, put it on a particular stand which is meant for the chandelier itself, and then each and every piece is cleaned with very care, with very precautions, and then they are again set and then the chandelier is again put back to the ceiling. Thorough cleaning of walls, windows and curtain tracks. Cleaning signage boards so that guest can have a proper look at the signs which are put. Thorough washing of washroom floors, walls, fixtures, fittings and shower curtains. Laundering of washable soft furnishings. Next is spring cleaning. that is also known as special cleaning. It involves periodic annual cleaning of hotel guest rooms or other areas carried out in off-season period. Now, off-season period is the time duration of the year when you have low occupancy in the hotel. Low occupancy means when there is less inflow of tourists in the hotel. So that is a off-season. The term is often used synonymously with deep cleaning. Spring cleaning may involve a complete overhaul of the rooms and is therefore scheduled for the off-season or very low occupancy periods. In spring cleaning, the whole floor can be blocked for the season of low occupancy time. The whole floor can be blocked and then the guest can be given the different other floors. Spring cleaning involves many tasks on which the housekeeping department works in close coordination with maintenance department as well as front office also. Intensive cleaning tasks may have to be carried out for which an entire floor of rooms will have to be taken off sale at a time. As I have already told, the whole floor can be blocked for the spring cleaning purpose. Spring cleaning tasks may include the following: a removal of all guest supplies, soft furnishings and carpets from the rooms, sending launderable articles to the laundry, polishing wooden furniture, shampooing of the upholstery and covering them with the dust sheets if they are not removed from the room, shampooing of the carpets, stripping and polishing of the floors, cleaning accessories such as lamps, lampshades and picture frames, stripping any wall covering such as paint or wallpaper and repainting of the walls if required, washing of ceilings and walls or repainting of both the places, thoroughly cleaning light fixtures, air conditioning vents and windows, thorough cleaning of bathrooms including walls, floors, tiles, fixtures and fittings, shower curtains, vacuuming cleaning the mattresses. If you think that they are really dirty, then you can change them, and in case they need to be cleaned with the vacuum, then that can also be done. Airing of the room, the windows can be opened so that the fresh air can come in and the foul smell can be removed from the rooms. Restocking the guest supplies, restoring soft furnishings and carpets. Once the cleaning and the maintenance of the room is over, then you can again relay the things. Clearing the rooms to the front desk for sale at the end of the thorough cleaning, so that you can again sell it to the guests and you can again start generating revenue from those rooms. That's all for today. And in the next video, we will study about cleaning procedures or cleaning processes. Till then, thank you. Have a nice day.